Welcome to BIV Today, the daily business program from the journalists at Business in Vancouver. I'm Hayley Woodin. My guest today is the CEO of Science World, Tracy Redies, joining me to talk about what her organization has experienced during the pandemic. Tracy, good to have you on the show. Thanks for coming on.
Oh, thanks very much, Hayley. Glad to be here.
We've spoken on this show about how the not-for-profit sector has been hit by this pandemic. Tell me a little bit about what Science World specifically has experienced this year.
Well, it's obviously been a very challenging year for Science World, probably its most challenging year in its history. And it's had a long history here. So, but, you know, we have seen obviously attendance levels drop like a rock. We're only really experiencing about 10 to 20% of our normal attendance. So, and that's where we've driven most of our revenue. So it's had a significant financial impact on us as well.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about that financial picture. In a normal year, what are the multiple sources of funding that you would normally rely on?
Yeah. Well, 85% of our funding typically came from gate revenue or ancillary revenue like parking and that's associated with people coming to see Science World. So that's been impacted significantly. You know, we are a nonprofit and we aren't funded by government. I know a lot of people think that, but actually before the pandemic, government revenues were less than 2% of our total revenue. So again, when you have a pandemic where people are not feeling comfortable to travel and go to places like they used to, that has a significant impact. And we'll probably see a drop of about $13 million in revenue this year as a result.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So tell me, what do you do? How do you respond?
Well, we're soldiering on. And, you know, we've obviously had to make some expense cuts, staffing cuts, unfortunately. And that's been the hardest thing because, you know, we've had a lot of people who have worked with Science World for more than 20 years. So that's been very challenging. We've made cuts to capital programs, so we're not investing like we had hoped to be able to do. So there's been a variety of things. Our staff, for the most part of this year, who are continuing to work with Science World, worked at 80% of salary. So a number of measures, and I think we'll soldier through. We've had some government support from the federal government in terms of CEWS, which has helped. But again, overall, a very challenging financial picture.
I know your advertising campaign that featured a young Dr. Bonnie Henry certainly raised a lot of awareness in terms of how much money it's raised. Has it been a successful campaign?
Well, you know, it's been a successful campaign on a number of fronts. I think it's really raised the profile of Science World in the province. And more importantly, I think it's highlighted if people are starting to get that it's really important to fund the future and future talent that we need in terms of STEAM literacy and ability to take those 21st century jobs. Science World has a big part to play in that. And the world needs more nerds is really a play on that we need more scientists, we need more mathematicians, we need more engineers. It's really important. And as we've seen this year, we've never needed science more, and science has come through, thankfully. So as we were talking before, we can all have some hope now that our lives will return to maybe a bit of a new normal, but at least a more normal.
Absolutely. Tell me a bit about the role corporate sponsors, corporate partners play in Science World as an organization, and maybe what role they can play moving forward.
Well, that's a really good point. I mean, we have a number of corporate sponsors that have helped us over the years, that have sponsored the development of our physical location. But, you know, this year, as a result of the pandemic, but also it was in part something we were planning to do anyways, we were just forced to accelerate it with the pandemic, is to get more and more of our programming online. And so we, in in a typical year, we would have outreach to students and teachers of about like 140 in the range of 140,000 people a year behind the scenes, helping them. Now, you know, as we're putting our programs online, we're able to extend that reach. And we're talking to a number of corporate partners and sponsors about that, because, you know, for most corporates nowadays, what they want to see is outcomes. They want to see, you know, their money go towards, you know, things that really change the bar, raise the bar. And I think that's what we're doing with our science-based programming and how we're putting it, pivoting to the online world.
As we both know, there are so many worthy causes deserving of our dollars and our attention. Do you look for alignment in the corporate world when you're assessing out or looking for a donor? Do you look for a company, say, in biosciences, life sciences, where there's that scientific connection?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, that's really important. And you know, the thing is that when you're talking about science or technology, it's pretty pervasive through every business and organization now. You know, we can't run our lives without technology. So it's actually, you know, you'd be surprised perhaps on some of the partners that we're talking about, but definitely we're looking in the technology and the science field, health sciences field, because that's really important. We're actually just about to launch a $10 million fundraising campaign, and we're hoping both corporates and individuals, step up to help us here. Science World has been an amazing, iconic organization that has essentially for many years funded itself through gate revenues. But, we need the community's help, and we're hoping that notwithstanding the fact that there are lots of charities out there, that people believe in science and the importance of science and STEAM education for the future of our children and our province. And I think we're a good bet.
Has part of this year your focus been on simply educating people about the role that Science World plays? I think everyone's familiar with your physical location. It can be a great daytime activity or evening activity for adults, but everything else you do in the community in the world of STEM.
Yes. Well, and again, this is, and we appreciate being able to speak with people like yourselves to help get the word out. But, even I, who's a mother of four, who's been to Science World many times, I didn't realize just how much Science World was doing behind the scenes. We train thousands of teachers every year to deliver science programs in their classrooms. We are reaching more people now with our programs. I'll give you an example. Girls in STEAM, which is a program that we do for 11 to 13 year olds, and it's essentially a day-long workshop. In 2019, we had 300 girls to our dome. It was oversubscribed and a great day. But in 2020, of course, we couldn't do that. However, we pivoted online, and we were able to deliver that program to 2,500 girls. And so we see a really bright future in terms of being able to realize our purpose, which is to increase STEAM literacy by leveraging the digital channels to show our programs and to particularly, you know, helping reach remote communities and places where, you know, it's maybe not that easy to access a high quality science education. So we just have to figure out how we also can drive revenue from that, because it's a different model. But I'm quite confident that, as we've cracked other nuts, we'll crack this one too.
I like that. In terms of the revenue you get from gate sales and ancillary sources, do you see that returning to normal when we get a vaccine? Is there a clear connection there between consumer confidence, having a vaccine, and you returning to some sense of normal?
Well, I think, no one has a crystal ball, and obviously this isn't going to be an overnight fix. And we're certainly have been planning that it'll probably take until, 2022 before we start to see more normalized attendance levels. And that's why it's important for us to, that's why we're going out to do a large fundraising campaign while we're looking at other sources of revenue. We've just launched our online store. We can't keep our Nerds t-shirts in stock. They're flying off the ground, or in the iCloud for want of a better description. But you know, we're very happy with that, and we plan to do more of that. So I think at the end of at the end of this, as we kind of return to a more normal, you know, our plan is to make Science World an even more resilient, stronger organization that has revenues, not just from gate attendance, but from other sources. And then we can continue to fulfill our mission to ignite wonder and empower dreams through science and nature. You know, it's a great mission, great purpose, and we all believe in it very strongly. So we're all committed to making this work.
Any final words for our audience, largely of business professionals and companies, maybe about your $10 million fundraising campaign or anything else happening at Science World?
Well, we'll be knocking on your doors, and we're just putting the final touches to you know, how we're going to what we're going to use the money for. And but no, I hope the business community recognizes the importance of Science World, in that. Again, we say that we're training the STEAM leaders of tomorrow today, and organizations like ourselves, science centers across the country, are very important to developing that innovation, that talent that is going to drive our economy forward in the 21st century. So we hope that many businesses in Vancouver you know, agree with us, but we're also conscious too that it's been a tough time for a number of businesses. But anyhow, more to come.
More to come. I think we're all closing the year very thankful for the nerds who are giving us vaccines and making progress in the world of science.
Absolutely. We all owe them an incredible debt of gratitude. It's amazing what has been accomplished here, and I hope the public recognizes that and is comfortable with the whole process, because the more we can get people vaccinated, the more people listen to the science, I think the more we'll be able to get back to maybe a slightly new normal, but at least one closer to what we've been experiencing this last year.
Absolutely. Tracy, thanks so much for coming on our show.
Thanks very much, Hayley. All the best, and have a wonderful 2021.
To you as well. That's Tracy Redies, CEO of Science World, and this has been BIV Today. I'm Hayley Woodin. Thanks so much for listening and watching. We'll be back with a new episode tomorrow.